Good morning, all of you. Welcome back to course Artificial Intelligence. Our today's topic of video is frames. Introduction to frame. So here we are going to discuss about another knowledge representation technique called as a frame. So in the last video we discussed about one of the knowledge representation technique called as a semantic network. So till now we understand that prepositional logic and predicate logic, these are two knowledge representation technique, but it is mathematical based. But suppose we should go for suppose we want the graphical representation of a knowledge, then we should go for semantic network. So we already discussed about these three techniques: prepositional logic, predicate logic, and the semantic network. Now in today's video we are going to discuss about the frame. So frame is also one of the graphical representation of a knowledge. This is another technique which is used for knowledge representation, and it is graphical based, just like a semantic network. But the way of semantic network of representing the knowledge is different in case of frame. So in case of frame, we are representing the knowledge just like a object. Maybe you are familiar with the schema diagram, or you are familiar with the concept of OOPS. So in that case we have object, and that object is also having attributes and its values. So frame is slightly different from the semantic network, but also we can say that it's a graphical representation of, it is used for graphical representation of a knowledge. Now let's discuss more about the frame. So frame is a common data structure used in AI to which includes all knowledge about a particular object. So we know that object is instance. Object is nothing but a instance. So frame is a kind of data structure that is being used in AI which includes all knowledge about the particular object, and it includes a collection of attributes along with the associated value which is used to represent a particular entity. Let's say entity, or you can say object or instance. So it possesses set of attributes, and its value is also there. Related to that attribute, there is some it is associated with some value. So that we can represent in case of a frame. So again we can say that frame is a framework for representing the knowledge. It is somehow similar to semantic network, but all the information relevant to object is held inside a particular node. Frames are also an extensive part of knowledge representation scheme, and frame representation of a knowledge in a frame, it just look like a classes. If you are familiar with the concept of class, you are familiar with the concept of OOPS concept, you already have knowledge about the schema diagram, then it will be very easier for you to understand the structure of frame. So let me show you the graphical representation of a frame. Actually frame consists of two parts, okay. One is a fixed part and second one is a slot, okay. So frame possesses these two parts. Okay, we are saying that frame is a collection. So we are talking about the frame that it is going to represent the information about a particular object, and that object possesses attribute along with the value. So this is a structure of a frame through which you can represent the knowledge. So it consists of two parts. One is a fixed part and second one is a slot. So slot is that portion where we need to specify such a variable whose value can be changed. Means a slot holds a variable data. Means in this case there is a possibility that we are going to change it. Means we will place such a values, we will place such attributes in the slot part which are going to be changed. But in case of fixed part, it consists of such attributes whose value is not going to be changed. So as its name suggests, fixed. Fixed means what? It is finalized, that value is not going to be changed. Let's take a simple example of a panda. Let's say panda is one of the object for which I have created this particular frame, and this frame consists of two part. One is a slot. So in the slot I mention the name. So name of particular panda is going to be changed. Suppose I say the name is A. Now after that I can also change its name to B. So it is a changeable, it is a attribute which we can change. Then height of panda, maybe the kid, when the panda is small, its height is again less, means as the panda is grown up, so height of the panda is changed. So in case of a slot, we are putting such a attributes whose value may get changed. And similarly, age is also a particular attribute whose value is going to change continuously. Then next part is a fixed part for this panda. So we can say color of a panda is constant. Though panda is a small panda is a small or large, whether panda is very miss the age of panda is less, then also it is color is that same, that is black and white. Then the number of years, that is not going to be changed. The food, what kind of food that panda is eating. So all kinds of panda is having the same kind of habit. They are going to eat the bamboo. So in this way, in the fixed part, we are mentioning such an attribute whose value is not going to be changed. And in the slot part, we are representing such an attribute whose value may change. So this is one of the representation of a frame. Then we discuss about what are the different types of frame. So in this case, we are going to discuss about three types of frame. One is a class frame, second one is a subclass frame, and third one is a instance frame. So what do you mean by class frame? Okay, so in case of a class frame, you can see class is a vehicle and it possesses attribute registered number, model, producer and owner. So this is a we can say class frame. Then this is the example of subclass frame. So in subclass frame, what we can say, if you are aware about the concept of inheritance, then in case of inheritance we have base class and the derived class. So similarly here we have base class as a vehicle and derived class as a car. So car is a derived class, whereas a vehicle is a base class. So here it is also being represented with the help of various attributes, that is registration number of the car, model number, producer, owner, number of door and engine. So this is another type of frame called as a subclass frame. And the third type of frame is instance frame. So we can say John's car. John is one of the instance of this subclass car. Means we have base class vehicle from which we have derived a subclass called as a vehicle. Sorry, we have derived a subclass as a car, and for that car we have one instance called as a John. John is an instance of a subclass car which is a derived which is derived from the base class vehicle. So this John's car also possesses some attribute. Similar kind of attribute is there: registration number, model, producer, owner, number of doors and engine. So these are the various types of frames that you can use to represent the information. So initially we have seen that frame can be used to represent the knowledge in the graphical way, but more or less it make use of a OOPS concept. And in this case we make use of a class and then object, class, subclass, object. So these are the three types of frames are there. Now the next, this is another example of a frame. Here you can see vehicle is a base class, whereas a truck, car, these are the two subclass frame we discussed. See, these three kinds of frame can be used in the various examples. So here we can have, we can say vehicle is a class frame, car is a subclass frame, truck is also a subclass frame, this is an instance frame. Then for this basket, again it is extended. Okay, so in this way we have represented the information from the base class vehicle. Subclass is derived called as a truck, and another subclass is derived called as a car, and from this we have derived one instance called as a John's car. So this is how one of the representation of a frame. So more or less you need to understand that frame always try to represent the knowledge in terms of object, just like object and class, and it possesses an attribute here where we can specify the name of attribute along with their values. And finally we are going to discuss about what are the benefits of frame. Actually here I have written semantic net, but it's a what frame. So here we are discussing about what are the benefits of frame. So first benefit is comparatively flexible and used by many applications in AI. So if you want to represent this kind of knowledge which possesses some inheritance, or you can say class object kind of thing is there, then frame is useful. Just I have shown you the example of this. Suppose I need to show the hierarchical kind of data, then this frame is useful. It is very easy to add slot for new attributes. So here you can add more number of attribute also. And finally, you can say it is very easy to understand and visualization. As I told you in the previous video also, that now we are looking for to visualize the thing. If a data is present in just numerical form, then we are not that much interested. But suppose we represent the data in an appropriate form, in an appropriate diagram, then it will be more useful. So it's better to represent in a graphical manner. So we can say that frame is another knowledge representation technique as that of semantic network. So semantic network and frame, these are the two graphical knowledge representation techniques. Thank you.